Dear friends, in this webinar, we shall be learning about triaging sick newborn babies. The word triage means sorting. Triage is a process of rapidly screening sick neonates when they arrive at the hospital and categorizing them in one of the groups depending on the urgency of care needed. The site of the facility where a neonate is first brought to the hospital, such as an emergency area or the reception, and the registration corner in the casualty should be the triaging area. All the staffs involved should be trained in the triaging process. The most experienced doctor present who is trained in neonatal care should undertake the responsibility of emergency treatment and management of such a neonate. By triaging, we classify the babies into the following three categories. First category, those needing emergency care. These babies require urgent intervention and emergency treatment and need to be admitted in the SNCU. Second category, those needing priority care. These babies need immediate assessment and priority treatment. They also need to be admitted in the SNCU. The final category are the non-urgent babies, those whose medical underlying condition does not merit immediate management or evaluation. Some of the examples of babies needing emergency care include babies with moderate to severe hypothermia, babies who are having apnea or gasping respiration, severe respiratory distress, central cyanosis, shock, coma, convulsions, or encephalopathy. Babies with priority signs include babies weighing less than 1800 grams, babies in cold stress, babies with respiratory distress, those who are irritable, restless, jittery, babies presenting with refusal to feed, abdominal distension, and those with severe jaundice or severe pallor or bleeding from any site, and also babies with major congenital malformations. All cases not categorized as emergency or priority, such as those with superficial infections or minor trauma, would be the examples of non-urgent cases. The process of triaging involves assessment of emergency signs, assess temperature and look for hypothermia, and assess if baby is hypothermic, assess airway and breathing, if the baby is apneic or has gasping respiration. It could be apneic spells or aspiration or blockade of airway. Assess if baby has respiratory distress, such as rate more than 60 per minute, retraction or grunting. Is there central cyanosis? We need to look into this. It is said to be present if lips and tongue are blue or mucosa in and around the mouth is blue.
Connect a pulse oximeter and check oxygen saturations.
Assess circulation. Look for evidence of shock. Are the hands and feet cold? Look for capillary filling time by pressing the front of chest and blanching the area and not the hand and feet. If the area takes more than 3 seconds to become pink again, it is suggestive of prolonged CFT. Check for the pulse. If the child has tachycardia and the pulse is weak and rapid, it is suggestive of shock. Assess for sensorium. Assess for response to stimulus and evaluate if baby is awake, responds to pain, or is unresponsive. Evaluate if the baby has convulsions, which may be generalized or localized.
Perform blood sugar to check for hypoglycemia.
Having assessed the vital signs, in the emergency treatment, we need to firstly manage the temperature. If the baby's temperature is less than 34 degrees, then do rapid rewarming till the temperature of 34 degrees reached. Subsequently, maintain the baby's temperature between 36.5 to 37.5 degrees centigrade. Keep the baby dry and the head, hands and feet covered. To maintain the airway, place the child in sniffing position. Place a shoulder roll under the shoulder to position the child. Clear the airway of secretions by suctioning if indicated. To assess breathing, support the child's respiration by using nasal cannula, which can be placed just inside the nostrils and secured with a tape. the flow rate can be maintained around 1 to 2 liters per minute. The child could also be placed under oxygen hood with oxygen flow of 5 to 8 liters per minute. Positive pressure ventilation will be required if the baby is apneic or having gasping respiration. The oxygen should be monitored by a pulse oximeter for monitoring oxygen saturation. To support circulation, if the baby is in shock, give an IV bolus of normal saline at the rate of 10 ml per kg over 20 to 30 minutes. Repeat bolus IV fluid if features of shock persist. Give blood transfusion if bleeding is the cause of shock. Initiate inotropes, dopamine or dobutamine, as the condition demands.
For a baby having convulsions, manage airway, correct hypoglycemia if present, and give anticonvulsant.
It is important to recognize that baby may have more than one underlying condition to treat. So, we need to look for all the underlying conditions and treat them.
So, to summarize, the key messages are, firstly, assess sick babies in a systematic manner. Secondly, categorize them into groups depending on urgency of treatment required. Then, manage the underlying condition. It is important to look for all possible underlying conditions causing sickness in the baby. Thank you.